Hi everyone, in this video, which is the second video for the direct kinematics section on robotics, we will be looking at the Denavit-Hartenberg or the DH representation. Now in my previous video, we discussed assigning frames for a robot manipulator. If you're not quite familiar on that, check it out by clicking the link up here. In this video, we will be using those frames to create a DH table, and from that, later on, a transformation matrix when moving from one frame to another. Without waiting any longer, let's get into it. Don't forget to like these videos, give me a thumbs up, and click that subscribe button. I'm Chums, and welcome to That's Engineering. Alright guys, so before we look at DH tables, let's have a look at our link joint parameters, the four values which make up our DH tables. Now these can be understood by considering two arbitrary joints. So let's just imagine a joint here, a revolute joint, connected through some sort of link to another revolute joint over here. Now each of these joints would have their joint axis. Right, so the first value is our AI-1, which is the link length. For this, it would be the length of the common perpendicular between both these two axes. So that would be your AI-1. Your second parameter would be the link twist. So if we assume this joint to be our ith joint, this would be our I-1. So this axis can be redrawn over here, sort of something like that. And this angle would be our link twist, alpha I-1. The third value is the link offset, which is the offset distance between the link and the common axis. So, sort of something like this. And theta I would be the rotation of the joint. So, typically, DI values will only exist for prismatic joints, because they move linearly up or down, left or right, while theta I values will usually exist only for revolute joints as they revolve around a particular axis, which means revolute joints should have a 0 DI, while prismatic values should have a 0 theta I. So these are the four definitions that we will be using to find these four parameters. It is best to keep these definitions in mind and understand them, as it would make problem solving much easier. Now, if you look at these definitions, like I mentioned earlier, only two axes are needed, the z-axis and the x-axis. In this case, for example, zi would refer to the axis under question, while zi+1 would refer to the next joint axis, and zi-1 would refer to the previous joint axis. Using these four values, we can form a DH table, or a Denavit-Hartenberg table. And using the values in a DH table, we can later find our transformation matrices. Using a particular equation. Now, using these definitions are best understood through an example. So let's have a look at it. So, looking at this example, we assigned the frames in the previous video. You can see there are three joints. You have a prismatic joint, a revolute joint, and another revolute joint. So just by looking at the diagram, you should be able to tell that the prismatic joint should have some value for di, and that would actually be given by this variable here, d1. The two revolute joints should have some value for theta, which would be theta 2 and theta 3. The frame for the tool was already given in the question, while the base frame was assigned in relation to the first frame. Now, this would be our DH table, and the first step would be to identify the axes. So we have three axes, 1, 2, 3 corresponding to our three joints. However, when setting the parameters for the DH table, we would always move from one frame to another. So in the first case, we will move from 0 to 1, then from 1 to 2, and 2 to 3. So let's consider the first case, moving from 0 to 1. Now for the first two parameters, A and alpha I minus 1, I would be equal to 0, because our ZI would be 0 and ZI plus 1 would be 1. But in the case of DI and theta I would be 1, so our XI minus 1 can be 0 and our XI can be 1. This is because we want to keep our XIs and ZIs in relation. So let's have a look at it. For AI minus 1, we want the distance from Z0 to Z1 about our X0. So the distance between our Z0 and our Z1 along X0. And you would see that this value is actually 0 because Z0 and Z1 are in line with each other, and so there is no displacement along the x-axis. The second value, alpha I minus 1, looks at the angle between Z0 and Z1 about x0. So this is the angle Z0 has to rotate to align with Z1 about x0 axis. And as they are both pointing vertically upwards and in line, this angle is 0. Now, I becomes equal to 1. Again, we want the distance for DI between our x0 to x1 about z1. So the distance between my x0 and x1 about z1 would actually be d1 because it is a prismatic joint. Whereas the angle from x0 to x1 about z1 would be 0. And this is because x0 and x1, so how we can rotate our x0 to match up with x1 about z1. So the rotation would be here. They're both in line and both pointing in the same direction. So the angle would be 0. There would be no rotation around z1. Now let's look at frame 1 to 2. Right, so now considering frame 1 to 2. So for the first two values, our I would be equal to 1. So our AI minus 1 would want our distance from Z1 to Z2 about X1. The distance between Z1 and Z2 in the direction of x1, and this would actually be the length of the link from z1 to z2. So we can imagine a parameter or the length of the link to be l1, and that would be your ai minus 1. Then the angle between z1 and z2 about x1. So this is the angle z1 must rotate to match up to Z2 if rotated about X1's axis. As both Z1 and Z2 are parallel and pointing in the same direction, this angle is 0. Now, we look at I equals 2 for the final two parameters. For DI, we want the distance between my X1 to X2 about Z2. The distance between my x1 and x2 in line of z2. So x1 and x2 are both on the same plane. There is no vertical displacement. So this is 0. for theta I, the angle between x1 and x2 about z2. So the angle x2 rotates away from x1 about z2, and this angle would be theta 2. So as you can see, this is a revolute joint. Hence, it has a 0 di but a theta value. While as previously, we were looking at a prismatic joint. So it has some di value, which is d1, but a 0 theta I value. Now you can repeat these steps for axis 2 and 3. And if you do so, you should get L2, where L2 is the link length from 2 to 3. Alpha I minus 1 should be 0, di should be 0, it's a revolute joint, and show theta, and so theta I should be theta 3. So that's how you assign the values to the DH table while considering the frames of the robot. Alright guys, so that's all for this video. If you guys liked it, please give me a thumbs up by clicking the like button below. If you have any questions or clarifications on the work I just did involving DH tables or the Denavit-Hartenberg representation, please feel free to leave a comment and I will do my best to get back to you. I hope this video helped, and if you haven't done so already, go ahead and click that subscribe button. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you guys in the next video.